Hello everyone, in this part 2 of complex numbers, I'll explain you standard form of complex numbers and operations on complex numbers. So let's start with the standard form. A complex number is an expression of the form a plus ib where a and b are real numbers. Such an expression is called standard form of complex number. And if we will denote z is equals to a plus ib, which is the standard form, then a is called the real of z and it is denoted by real of z. B is known as imaginary of z and it is denoted by imaginary of z. Now if a is equals to 0, then we will say z is purely imaginary. Z is purely imaginary. So, if we have to prove that z is purely imaginary, we have to prove the real part 0. That means in this part, we will prove anyhow a is equals to 0. And if b is equals to 0, then it is known as that z is purely real. Purely real. Now, operations on complex numbers. If we have two complex numbers, z1 is equals to a plus ib and z2 is equals to c plus id, then addition means first of all add real parts plus I addition of imaginary parts. We can do with one example. Let z is equals to 5 plus 3i and z2 is equals to 3 plus 2i. Now z1 plus z2 add of real part 5 plus 3 plus I 3 plus 2. It means this become 8 plus 5i and this is the addition. In the same way subtraction, z1 minus z2, it means z1 is here, it means first real parts 5 minus 3 and plus 3 minus 2i, it means this become 2 plus I. So this is the subtraction or two complex numbers, subtraction of two complex numbers. Now multiplication, whatever result is coming, that will come after simplification. How it will come? Look at this thing, z1, z2, a plus ib and we have c plus id. Now do the multiplication, ac plus iad plus ibc plus I square bd. I square means minus 1, it means ac minus bd, sorry, ac minus bd only. And this plus AD plus BC. So this is the multiplication of two complex numbers. Now this is very very important point. If we have a non-zero complex number Z, then there exists a non-zero complex number Z inverse such that Z into Z inverse or Z is equals to Z inverse into Z is equals to 1. And this Z inverse is known as the multiplicative inverse. So whenever we have to find out the multiplicative inverse of a non-zero complex number, which is denoted by Z inverse, then we have to find out 1 upon Z only. Now we will do some questions related to this explanation. Now in first question, we have three parts in which we have to express in the form of a plus ib. So let's start with the first question, a part. We have 2i minus I square whole square. Now a minus b whole square, a square plus b square, it means I square square, and then minus 2ab, it means 2i into I square. So this become minus 4 because I square means minus 1. This is I 4 means plus 1. And this become I square means minus 1. It means this become plus 4i. So what this become? Minus 3 plus 4i. Now this is the B part. In B part we have 1 minus I whole raised to power 4. We will write 1 minus I whole square raised to power 2. It means 1 plus I square minus 2i whole square. So what this become? 1 minus I minus 2i whole square. 1 I square means minus 1. This is cancel out. It means what this become? Minus 2i whole square. It means minus square means plus. This is 4 I square. I square means minus 1, that's why this is minus 4. Now in this C part, we have 5 plus root 2i upon 1 minus root 2i. Whenever we are doing this type of questions, we will use the same procedure which we were using in the rationalization. How will we do? Look at this thing, 5 plus root 2i and this is 1 minus root 2i. Now, denominator, whatever the sign, change with this signs, rest of term as it is, 1 plus root 2i. Now in denominator, always there will be the identity, a square minus b square, root 2i whole square. Now here, 5 plus 5 root 2i plus root 2i, and this plus root 2 means 2i square. 2i square means, I square means minus 1, 5 minus 2, 3 plus 6 root 2i upon 1, and this become minus minus plus 2. What is common? 3 common, 1 plus 2 root 2i upon 3, 3, 3 cancel out, it means 1 plus 2 root 2i. So this is the way to convert into standard form. Now there is one more question. In this question, we have to solve this for x and y, and where x and y are reals. So in this second question, we have 1 plus I, this is x square, plus 6 plus I, and this is 2 plus I, this is y. Now x square plus I x square plus 6 plus I is equals to 2y plus iy. It means x square plus 6 plus I common, x square plus 1, this is 2y plus iy. This is the case of equality of two complex number. Therefore, we will say on equating. Once you will do on equating, x square plus 6 is equals to 2y, first equation, x square plus 1 is equals to y. This is the second equation. Now, on subtraction, minus 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 5 is equals to y. It implies that y is equals to 5. Now, from equation 1, what will come? X square plus 6 is equals to 10. X square is equals to 4. X is equals to plus minus 2. Now, don't forget to give the answer of this question in comment box. Thanks and God bless you.